you for watching this CBS College Sports presentation. We now join our regularly scheduled program, already in progress.
We welcome you to the Peterson Events Center on the campus of the University of Pittsburgh for this Big East encounter between these old rivals, Villanova and Pittsburgh. Early going now, Villanova has scored the first basket of the game. We have 18-14 to go in the first half of play. And Gilbert Brown, one of three seniors, playing their final home game today. Inbounds the ball. Here is Ashton Gibbs.
Interesting to see how they control their emotion, Vern. A big day for them and their families, the seniors.
Wanamaker, into the corner. Brown needs five to pass 1,000 for his career. Misfires on that one. And here comes Malik Waynes all the way to the basket, and it's 4-0.
Nice penetration there. The guards can do a job. Fisher very strong. The ability to put it on the deck and finish as well.
Wanamaker. Nice cut. Yes, it was. Nasir Robinson was fouled as he goes up, and he will go to the free throw line.
Yeah, they personify team, don't they, Pitt? And on the other end, Villanova been patient on the offense early, but when they get the opportunity, good, strong attack by Corey Fisher. They need a real solid effort out of him.
Foul is on Yaru, and Robinson is at the line. Nasir Robinson shooting free throws, misses the first for Pitt. Villanova has jumped out to a quick 4-0 lead on baskets from Yaru and Fisher.
Robinson, one of those guys that just does his job. Double-double against South Florida. Good cutter, good rebounder.
Now Corey Fisher brings it up. Malik Waynes. Corey Stokes unavailable for Villanova today because of a left hamstring. We'll talk a little bit more about that as the game goes on. He is here, but he is unable to go.
And they're hoping to get him for next week. He thinks he'll be ready. Tweaked it once before.
Here's Pena.
Well, Pena's a key guy with that pick and pop. Make that 15-footer.
Three on the shot clock. And Fisher is fouled as he goes up. Foul is called on Brown.
On the pass. They should have shot it. Normally, yeah. One of the best in the country at drawing attention. Seldom. He's out of the Bronx, so I'm sure you've seen some tape of Walt Frazier. He's one of the best in the country at drawing your attention, getting your numbers, and hugging you.
Non-shooting foul, so Waynes throws it in. Isaiah Armwood just comes on the bench now for Jay Wright's Villanova team.
And this is a big team, as big as you'll see Villanova. They normally have three guards, occasionally four. Cheek and Armwood, wing and small forwards as well.
Dominic Cheek gets the start for Corey Stokes today for the Wildcats, who have lost three in a row. Here's Fisher, jumper. Nope, off the back iron. Rebound in the hands of Wanamaker, no numbers here. But he penetrates anyway and gets the basket.
Boy, nice paces, wasn't it? Able to slow it down, hesitate, and find one of his guys attacking the tin.
4-3 in the early going at Peterson Events Center.
Have you seen Villanova be this patient in a while?
No.
They're reversing the ball.
Yeah.
If they get an early one, they're going to take it. Late. Use that high five screen and go. Good kick.
Off the glass and foul is called. That's going to send Armwood. Time call in Pittsburgh. This is senior day. Nick Rivers, 1 of 4, introduced before the game.
Hurry in and take advantage of Sears' Big Home Appliance Savings Event. Get 30% off all Kenmore appliances. And get 15% off all other brands. Plus, come in for Sears' semi-annual Dyson event, where you can save 20% on all Dyson floor care products. Hurry into Sears for these incredible savings. Search Sears appliances for our everyday best prices guaranteed. Sears.
AT&T wants to make sure you don't miss out on NCAA basketball coverage this season. AT&T and CBSSports.com keeps you informed on the latest college basketball news. Stay up to date with all the highlights, scores, and analysis of NCAA basketball games from CBSSports.com right on your AT&T phone. Standard data rates apply. AT&T is the exclusive wireless partner of the NCAA, keeping you in the game with all the college basketball action, at home or on the go.
Villanova playing shorthanded today with Corey Stokes unable to go. They do have a one-point lead now. We've played 4 minutes and 5 seconds.
The crazy part about it, with Stokes out, forced to play a little bit bigger. See, not only today, but as they move forward, I think it'll give the big guys some confidence. Then you get him back, and he can really drill the shot. Great catch and shoot guy. Learned how to put it on the deck a little bit, and a good rebound.
And again, the injury was a hamstring pull that occurred in practice on Thursday. Isaiah Armwood at the free throw line for Villanova. One more.
This is a game where Yaru could do some damage, I think. We'll space him once he gets back in. We'll load up on the low box.
A couple of ugly free throws from Armwood.
Folks won't be happy to hear that.
No, I know that.
Straight up minimum by Villanova. And
nice quick hands, Pena. But Nasir Robinson gets it back. And it's taken away by Waynes. Here's Fisher. Splits the two off the glass. Rebound no good. That one is.
Right, good effort. And that's the guy that really has to play well, Pena. Do some damage, not only on the glass, but that 15-footer makes them a different team.
Pena, one of the seniors for Villanova, and their lead is up to 6-3.
A tough match. They just switch it now. Armwood had been on Wanamaker.
Dominic nice. Cheek. Oh, there's another turnover.
Great anticipation.
2-on-2. There's the dish. Dominic Cheek off the glass.
Waynes with a great read. Jamie Dixon not happy at all. That timeout.
30-second timeout.
Escape convention. Escape definition. Escape compromise. Introducing the most fuel-efficient luxury car available. The radically new 42-mile-per-gallon CT Hybrid from Lexus. Welcome to the darker side of green.
Final day of the Big East regular season play, and these are the current standings. Notre Dame wins at UConn today. So that puts them into a tie with Pittsburgh and means Pittsburgh needs this win to secure the top seed next week. Villanova 9-8. They do lead in this one 8-3, but they have been sliding. They've lost their last three in a row.
And I'll tell you, they play defense like they've been playing early here. Great anticipation. Scatter report steal by Waynes and the ensuing easy goal.
Yaru fronting McGee. They're having a little battle in the low post. Here's the jumper, Wanamaker. No, put back, no. Rebound. Waynes has it.
How could you say little battle with those two bodies? They are big youngsters.
Jamie Dixon going to go to his bench here in just a moment. Now here's Cheek. Armwood, Cheek, Malik Waynes, Pena outside. They spread it out.
And Bernard, taking a page out of Notre Dame's book when they came in here. The burn offense of Notre Dame, reverse the ball, get a screen late. Nice.
Yeah, Wayne split it, but there's Gilbert Brown with the steal at the other end. He's got two.
You got to be sure when you split the screen, you got to get down, hunch over that basketball. You can't kick it away and get a little run out.
13:40 remaining first half and a three-point margin. Armwood not a threat to shoot from out there, so Brown backs off.
Took us this long to get our order last night.
Well, they are taking the air out of the ball, aren't they?
They sure are. Tough shot.
Off the back rim. Tip. Loose ball. Ashton Gibbs has it for Pitt.
They got a double foul. They're running the floor. Look, they're pointing at Armwood.
13-15 to go first half. Peterson Event Center on the campus, University of Pittsburgh. We have played just over 6 minutes and 40 seconds. Villanova jumped out to a 4-0 lead. Just an incidental note, that was the first lead they'd had in a game in 117 minutes. It's 8-5 right now, and a double foul Bill Raftery just called.
And you bring up the past. I mean, all the Villanova fans are upset at you with that little nugget, but they have struggled, no question about it, particularly the Notre Dame game. They were not themselves. Notre Dame played at such an extraordinarily high level. And Jay's kids, I thought, got some composure late, started to make some shots, and he felt they had a good practice week.
Villanova playing without Corey Stokes, their leading scorer. Stokes pulled a hamstring in practice on Thursday in Philadelphia. He is with the team but unable to play. They hope to get him back for the Big East tournament next week. And so Dominic Cheek got the start today.
And the referees are over there checking on the double foul to see if there was any indiscretion, any extracurricular activities. But Cheek's one of those kids that lends a lot defensively. Great length. He can play a couple of positions, can make the three, puts it on the deck. But you love to have Stokes the way he drills open shots.
Our officiating triumvir today, John Cowell, James Breeding, and Jamie Lucky. And a little consultation over at the monitor. There's Corey Stokes in the background, 16 points per game. This is the fourth game he's had to miss this year. The double foul called on Gilbert Brown and Isaiah Armwood.
Interesting, when they stopped the flow, Pitt had a little run going, a little fast break. All that incidental contact, I think, hurt them.
Trayvon Woodall has come on during the break now. He's got the ball in his hands. Woodall, point guard.
They pick up the pace with him, too. They'll run a little bit more. Good defender, picks up charges. First, well coached as a youngster at St. Anthony's with the Hall of Famer Bob Hurley.
Ball tipped out of bounds. 8-5. Villanova, over the years, has never won at the Peterson Event Center. They're 0-3.
A lot of people could say that.
Yeah, that's right.
Maybe when he knocks him out here.
Woodall. Matter of fact, parenthetical note, this is the 161st game played in this arena. And Pittsburgh is 148th.
Nice pull-up.
Yeah.
16-1 this year. Notre Dame the only loss, but nice pull-up. Gibbs, healthy. Terrific stroke. Now has a middle game as well as that deep three.
And that Notre Dame loss at home here by 5 makes this game relevant, because with Notre Dame's win at UConn earlier this afternoon, Pitt needs to win the tiebreaker and have the top seed in the Big East tournament next week.
What a job Mike Bray's done to those kids. They're trying to establish a little inside game. Not as effective with the ball screen out high.
Fisher, turn around. No. Armwood up. No. Yarou. Okay, here are the 10 on the floor right now. Waynes, Fisher, Yarou, Armwood, and Pena. Of course, Trayvon Woodall just came on. And Gibbs, Patterson, Woodall, and Dante Taylor, along with Nazir Robinson.
You know, as noted earlier, I think this is going to help Villanova come tournament time. The big guys getting more opportunities, playing a front line, what you might call a more normal size front line versus the guard use, so they can play a couple different ways.
Armwood out on Woodall. There's the trap. Now, you saw the Notre Dame Villanova game Monday night. And what a clashing that was.
Oh, yeah, just the opposite. I mean, one not playing well at all, and Notre Dame just knocked it three down. Look at this kid around the rim. The Sibby goaltender, good call. Wow,
it
Robinson,
is.
Really nice fade to get the catch, and then the ability to get to the rim. Solid play, does a lot of good things. Get up, big fella. One way to stop it.
I also will my private jet, my island in the Maldives, and full control of the family business to my soulmate, Angel. Finally, to my only son, Chauncey, I bequeath my DirecTV and its vast collection of 6,000 shows and movies.
DirecTV now gives you instant access to 6,000 shows and movies at no extra charge.
Yeah! Woo! Thank you! Yeah!
Don't just watch TV. Direct TV.
Unrestrained. Unexpected. And unlike any hybrid you have ever known. Introducing the most fuel-efficient luxury car available. The radically new 42-mile-per-gallon CT Hybrid from Lexus. Welcome to the darker side of green.
So this is Enzo, the artiste behind my wardrobe. You know, when I got him on E-Trade, he was all like,
"Oh, no, I cannot do investing."
That's actually a perfect Enzo. But after a couple educational videos and a little hand-holding from customer support, next thing you know, he's got a stunning portfolio. Now he's planning to retire in Tuscany. We're both pretty emotional about it. Shh. Don't say a word. You're welcome.
E-Trade. Investing unleashed.
Jack Link's Beef Jerky presents Messin' with Sasquatch.
Hey, look. Check this out.
Hey, buddy. Try this.
Mmm, it's real good.
You can do it.
Come on.
Yeah, try the poke. Come on. Yeah, try. Yum, yum, yum.
Jack Link's Jerky. Feed your wild side.
CBS Sports College Basketball coverage is sponsored by AT&T. Rethink possible. Sears. And by Lexus. Escape convention in the radically new Lexus CT Hybrid. All kinds of possibilities for Villanova. If they win today, they'll stay alive for a first-round bye. They won't have to play next Tuesday at Madison Square Garden. Pitt needs a win to clinch the title outright and the number one seed in the Big East tournament that begins Tuesday in Madison Square Garden.
And you got to consider Villanova, too, with Stokes injured. And, you know, not really the depth that they thought they would have coming into the season. This is a big one for them. Get that extra day off, don't you think?
Oh, my goodness. Corey Stokes, they hope to have him available. Again, if you joined us late, injured his left hamstring in practice Thursday on campus. So it is Fisher and Waynes, Dominic Cheek, Pena, and Yaru on the floor for the Wildcats.
And they've been very patient. And Pittsburgh's one of those teams. They play that three-point line. Very solid, great help defense team. Taylor now got the Yaru assignment. So they can get a touch for the big guy.
And again, they work on the clock. It's now at five. And a foul call.
A little nickel dimer by Wanamaker. He can't believe it, playing against his old teammate from Roman Catholic. 2 years older. Sort of the mentor in their younger days.
Brad Wanamaker, one of the four seniors on the team. Nick Rivers, a walk-on, will not expect to play. But you've got Gilbert Brown, McGee, and Wanamaker, who some think might be a candidate for Player of the Year.
Oh, he's in the hunt. I mean, because Hansbrough's been great. Kemba Walker's had a wonderful year. Hardy, another guy.
Right.
St. John Dwight had a great year. They have a little communication problem. Two Natalie attired coaches. We can learn something from these two. Jay, of course, has three or four guys to carry his clothes on the road. We have to do our own. Jamie's more like us. He carries his own wardrobe.
The issue here is apparently the possession arrow. And I guess Jay Wright won. That one no good. Offensive board. Pena falls down. No travel. He got rid of it at the time. And
you know, when you fall down, goodness, no advantage kind of. He gave it up. Wow. That's an unusual call.
Sure is. 3-second violation. The second turnover for Villanova.
He was in there. I'm waiting to hear from Art Highland. He'll tell me I was talking. Sure, officials. No question he was in there, but no advantage.
We near the midway point of the first half. Villanova and Pitt meeting for the second time. Oh, my goodness.
He can elevate Taylor. Dante
Taylor.
A daunting approach. Stinton. McDonald's All-American.
Yeah, first one in 22 years here.
And one of those guys, he's learning how to play. That's what happens at Pitt. They get better and better each year under the tutelage of Jamie.
Well, Jamie Dixon's team, 25 or more wins each of the last 6 years. Here's Cheek, puts it on the floor. Back to Waynes. Again, the shot clock at 5. Spin move, fade away. Got it.
He has improved so much in that lane. Finish it. He's got a floater, a runner. That's a pull up and square in the body at the 10.
First Villanova points in 5 minutes.
Look at this. Look at the matchup. Richardson with Waynes. They don't take advantage. He's not one of their go-to guys. Now they switch back. Cheek.
Here's Woodall. Off the dribble. Patterson. Entry pass and a foul over the top.
Well, how about the ability around the rim? You don't put a body on number 11. You can just say goodnight. He'll take you and your family with you. Boy, impressive physically. Imposing with the elevation.
Jamie Dixon's going to his bench. Lamar Patterson out. Ashton Gibbs back on the floor. Wanamaker. J.J. Richardson is also on the floor.
Interesting what he said to us yesterday. He tries to get a lot of guys in that first half. Confidence developed as the season progresses, but certainly late in the game, if they go to them, they're ready.
And there's a whistle. Build your brackets with Lowe's and CBS Sports on Facebook. Facebook, I beg your pardon. Play against your friends. And for a chance to win a trip to the 2012 Final Four, sign up at Facebook.com/brackets. Isaiah Armwood picks up his second foul and a quick hook. He'll go to the bench.
Yeah, you don't want to pick those with that distance from the hoop. Wayne's such a valuable performer, too, and Jay just saying to relax a little bit.
Sophomore out of Philly from Roman Catholic, as Bill said, that's his first foul. 11-10. Pittsburgh won the first matchup between these two, 57-54. That was on campus at the Pavilion. First loss for Villanova at home in that facility in 4 years.
And you can see where they're attacking when they think they have it and burning some clock when they don't.
Wanamaker gets the screen from Richardson in the pick and roll.
He's got a great crossover handle, too, Wanamaker. Tough matchup for Pena, I think, away from the goal.
Wanamaker, there's Pena defensively. And Guru.
They got the three?
Yeah.
Two of them in one half. What's going on here, bro?
I don't know.
We had a more than a 3 second violation where we were last night, that is. About Villanova right now, they're running something, not standing still, and then late they're looking for a show by a big guy.
James Bell on the floor, number 32.
Nice look
into the corner, entry pass. Yaru tough handling the ball off the glass. No, got to the board and a free throw.
Wow, did he stick with it? This kid's going to be a big time player as he learns, plays more games, just gets after it. In Philly, Moses Malone was a guy that used to throw it up and go chase it. That's reminiscent of MM at his best. How about that? Number 13 to the 10.
Lucas Yaru, of course, picked up basketball late in his life. He's a native of Benin, West Africa. And he gets the first free throw of the game for himself. And that is a three-point play. And Villanova up by two.
Now, you've been all over the world. Have you been there?
I have not been.
I know you're a traveling man.
Yeah, Miss Benin.
And right now, a little 2-3 zone to see if they can force Pitt to miss the jumper.
Ashton Gibbs. Bell's there defensively. Back outside. Woodall. Under 8 now. Here's Gibbs. No.
That's his spot, too. That little angle, either side. Gibbs usually converts it. May rush it a little bit. This is very reminiscent of the Notre Dame game.
Is it really?
Yeah, yeah, very much so. Using the clock, lulling Pitt.
Nice pass. Back outside. Bell lost it.
Watch it.
We almost had a three-man boot there.
Wow.
James Bell almost joined us. I admire him. I'm kind of glad he didn't, though.
Sonic, where you'll find thousands of drink combinations expertly mixed, like Cherry Coke, Strawberry Minute Maid Lemonade, Cherry Limeade Slush, and Vanilla Fanta Orange. Or create your own. Half price every day during happy hour from 2 to 4 p.m. Drive in and check your bag sticker to play Sonic's Matchmaker game. You could win a $5,000 Amazon.com gift card or one of over 50,000 free combos.
The reasons for owning a Ram are everywhere. You just gotta listen. The new 2011 Ram Outdoorsman, our latest calling. Ram.
Now during Truck Month, get a no extra charge Hemi V8 plus 0% financing for 60 months on Ram 1500.
Is it a place for everything? Is it enough space for a banquet? Is it everyone's favorite restaurant? It's the LG French Door Refrigerator with Slim Space Plus Ice System for maximum shelf space. So is it a refrigerator or something better?
Cut! What's that doing on my set?
Product placement, sir. Whenever we feature a product in a scene, we get tons of free stuff.
Here we go.
Really? My lady?
A sure sign of a good time. Just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
More Bud Light?
Low-scoring first half, 7:25 to go. Before the break, Villanova up by two. Points off turnovers.
One thing about Pittsburgh, they value the basketball, only average 11 and change. And when you cough it up and lead to opportunities at the other end, and just inadvertent use here, the getting the runouts is what the devastating part can be. That's just a great read defensively by Waynes. With a little flex screen on the baseline, little kick and cheek.
Taking it hard to the rim.
Pittsburgh won the first game, as we mentioned, February 12th. Since that date, 3.5 weeks ago, Villanova has averaged only 28 points per first half, and they're hitting only 36% from the field in first halves. They've really gotten off the sluggish starts.
I don't think they'll be upset if they don't get 28 today. They don't want to mix.
Nice penetration.
There's Pena with a block. Wanamaker has it. That's a fake for three. Gibbs.
They love to run him off that, make him shoot the two.
There's Gibbs for three.
That's why. That's his angle. Everybody's got an angle. Some are better than others.
Yeah, I've heard a few of yours. Gibbs has 5 points. And, of course, Notre Dame just burned this Villanova team with 23-point goals Monday night.
Mm-hmm. Now, they're usually pretty good at guarding the three. Not Monday night.
No. At the other end. And this has been lacking Villanova's offensive arsenal.
Well, that changes their whole game.
Yep.
The attitude, the defensive system, you can't get set up. When they shoot it, they're a different basketball team. And a little nickel dimer by Fisher. We know he's a little overzealous. And that happens, too. You make that shot, you get a little juice flowing, you want to get after them.
Second foul.
Not one you want by your lead guard.
J.J. Moore comes on the floor, number 44. Trayvon Woodall heads to the bench, and Ashton Gibbs is at the free throw line. Missed three earlier this season. Join Buick in the NCAA in celebrating human achievement with the Buick Human Highlight Reel coming in March.
Lester gives by Seton Hall Preparatives. Kevin McDonald's mentor. I recruited Kevin McDonald. He went to Penn. A very talented player. Bob Farrell, the longtime coach. Old neighborhood school of Vine.
Ah.
In the old days. Great success. Lester's brother's going to Maryland. A good basketball player as well.
First tie of the game now, 16-16.
You know, Rolly Massimino would be proud of Jay running this now. 1985, usually
yeah.
The time, tease him. Not a good foul, McGee. That's what happens. You sort of lull them into a false sense of security.
Well, I'm sure Rolly is watching down in Florida. He's got his Northwood Seahawks into the NAIA tournament, 30-3.
Mm-hmm.
And the number one seed. They'll play at the College of the Ozarks March 10th.
Well, they were number one for about a month in the country.
Right.
I think they're the number two seed of the tournament, though.
Is yes, right? They yeah. are. That's right.
And Rolly's done a great job with his kids. And 5 years in a row, they've been in the tournament. And don't forget, in 85 at Pitt, Rolly told his kids, if you don't play hard in the first 3 minutes of the second half, I'm taking you out. They didn't play hard enough for him, and we know the result. They won it all. They got beaten badly that day.
They were defeated by 23 in 85 in that last regular season game. You did the game, right?
I did, and I didn't realize it, but Frank Lieber, your old buddy, God right. bless him, we picked the Villanova bench for the Player of the Game Award, and his son, R.C., said, Dad, you know, I was a Player of the Year for you once, or Player of the Day, I should say. And the rest is history, though. What a run for the Roses in Kentucky, too.
Yep. Well, they lost that last game, and they were 18-9, and then went on that magical six in a row and defeated Georgetown.
Now, that flex is working, but they haven't gotten the angle for the right pass.
On with got airborne. Here it comes, Wanamaker. Whoa, he lost it.
Oh, the bad foul,
yes.
Second one, I believe, Vern.
That is the second. Well, Jamie Dixon was reminding me yesterday afternoon that they played Northwood in an exhibition game back on October 31st. Pitt did. Rolly brought his team up here. Jamie, it's always fun to see Coach Massimino.
He's a Hall of Famer. Anytime I can coach against him, I'm going to learn. J.J. Moore had a big game in that exhibition. Doesn't see much time, but that's how they develop players here under Jamie.
You think Massimino is bursting with pride now that we've devoted the last 5 minutes talking about him?
Unless he wouldn't talk to me if he didn't. He threatened me. He knows people.
4:45.
Nice long.
Oh, beautiful. Robinson up and under.
Gibbs more than just a three-point shooter, developing a tunnel game.
Robinson has seven. He's off a double-double in the win down at South Florida on Wednesday night when this Pitt team a little lethargic in the first half, but they just ripped it open in winning big. Hit 11 of their first 12 in the second half. Again, the shot clock down. Whoa, threw up a prayer travel.
He thought he got hit, but that's what they're trying to get the dribble, but gorgeous understanding of where how to make the pass and where to be. Not much of an angle on that delivery, but Gibbs with the left hand, just a great feel. And he has been free. It's the angle of the delivery that has hurt them.
Jay Wright goes under his bench again and brings Maurice Sutton on, number 25. 6'11", sophomore.
He gets his hands on a lot of things, changes shots around the rim, rebounds.
Offense, yes. Pena established his position, and it's an offensive foul. Time call.
Its profile is sculpted for optimal aerodynamics. It reduces wind resistance,
in an irresistible sort of way. The all-new Ford Focus, with up to 40 miles per gallon highway.
It's another perfect day out here today.
Can I get you anything else?
We gotta get back to work.
On the move. We even saw a kid taking a bath in a water fountain. Whoa, I spoke too soon. This just in. A freak storm is blowing into the area. We're going to be experiencing hurricane-force winds and dense fog, followed by sheets of driving spray. Stay inside, hunker down, grab a beer. This is gonna be a long one.
Buffalo Wild Wings. You have to be here.
We're receiving reports of hail the size of... Oh, boy.
It might be hard to believe that the new Focus can virtually park itself till you actually see it park itself. The all-new Ford Focus with class-exclusive active park assist.
You're watching NCAA basketball on CBS.
The couple that prays together.
If she's not alive, you're both going to regret it.
Stays together. A new CSI Miami CBS Sunday.
Monday, Dave's got the one and only Betty White.
For an 89-year-old broad, I couldn't be happier.
Plus, Kim and Kourtney Kardashian and a call from Regis Monday.
AT&T and CBSSports.com keep you up to speed on the latest NCAA basketball highlights, scores, and analysis right on your AT&T phone, whether at home or on the go. Vern Lundquist, Bill Raftery, Peterson Events Center on the campus of the University of Pittsburgh, Pitt, and Villanova, a two-point game.
At your age, I know you like the walls.
Yes.
You're not much of a jitterbugger. You got your walls today, don't you?
My walls?
Well, I mean, the Villanova. Just,
I see.
Slowing the boat down a little bit. Yeah, wisely, I think.
A waltz. I was thinking foxtrot, you know. You and I Dancing with the Stars. They haven't called you yet, have they?
No, I don't think they will either.
Yeah. They've called some unusual people, I'll tell you that. 3:40 to go.
And once again, as low as they can go without a jack.
Waynes has it. Fisher, under 10 on the shot clock again. 3:28 to go. Five. Long jumper, Waynes off the front rim. Rebound, Ashton Getz. Whoa! Sutton went for the steal from behind and fell on the floor hard.
He is lanky, though. He's got his nails on that one. Good hands.
Yes, Waynes.
Help your post.
There's Sutton.
Great job. They help the post defender. And they have not done a good job, Pitt. Generally, they enter the basketball to the low post beautifully. Not faking. They're making the extra look.
Now Pitt backs off. 2:50 to go. 18-16.
The official's got to be careful with driving and banging somebody.
Well, let's see who they got. Robinson or Dante Taylor. Which one?
A nice pinch by Pitt. That's their type of defense, though. They collect at the ball on the penetration. You just see right here, there's two people and a support in the back. And number 11, Taylor.
Coming up on AT&T at the half, join Greg and Greg Gumbel and Anthony, along with Seth Davis, for all the scores and highlights and the latest NCAA tournament news, plus a Naismith watch presented by AT&T. That's all coming up on AT&T at the half. Villanova, 76% at the line for the year. They're now 1 of 6.
Well, the key thing was Fisher was going to come out of the game to save him. So he's got to play smart now. Cheek is up at the desk. He's got to make the free throw to get him in.
Fisher's an 80%, 79. Let's be specific. Percent for the year. And they haven't been getting the line much in recent days. Here's Gibbs.
And the guards do get the foul. One of those guys gets there as a 5 free throws.
Inside the arc, that's for 2. 20-16. A 6-0 run, and this 4-point margin is the largest Pitt advantage in the game.
Now, if you want to stay with this offense, you've got to stay in touch with Pitt. Once it gets out there, you're going to have to go play a little bit. Standing.
Five on the shot clock. Nice. There's Sutton. Oh. Good. The tip. No. Over the top. It's going to be called on Villanova.
Very tough team to drive on. They bang you in a legal fashion. You don't get clean looks. And generally, they do a better job checking out.
And here's your problem.
Yeah.
That's Fisher's third foul.
And that's all because he missed the free throws. Now, they're going to check to make sure they get the right guy, though.
.216 with 93 seconds to go, and they're checking. They did call it on Fisher. They're checking to see who the shooter is.
You know, the difference when you think of Notre Dame and Villanova, they have so many perimeter shooters at Notre Dame that when you drive and help, there's the ability to find someone. And you know, right now, guys not making shots. Love this hustle here. Let's see if they got him underneath. Yeah, it could have been. I mean, he was there unless they go for Armwood in the rear. I think they're sticking with it. Yeah, number three.
Okay.
Yeah.
So Corey Fisher, and again, Corey Stokes, unable to go today because of a pulled hamstring. He's on the bench. Hopeful to get him back in the Big East tournament next week.
Well, when you're struggling, you mentioned the free throw, 78-79% by Fisher. And not making him, you can't get him out of the game. He ends up getting number three. That can change the whole complexion of the game.
Lamar Patterson at the line for Pitt. Of course, the Panthers playing not only for a number one seed in the Big East, and they have to win this game to win the tiebreaker over Notre Dame, but the number one seed. They're very much in the conversation for the number one seed overall as we near Selection Sunday and March Madness on CBS in collaboration with Turner Sports this year.
Now, Pitt just doesn't jump out at you. I mean, you have to witness it firsthand. I mean, it's not a glaring beauty. It's just total dedication fundamentally.
Eight unanswered for the Panthers. And again, the shot clock under 10.
Well, that helps. Doesn't it? Villanova was struggling. Really not getting much out of it late, and a giveaway by Taylor out there.
Well, now they need to make the free throws. They are in the double bonus, as that is the 10th team foul on Pitt. So Waynes, who was an 81% free throw shooter over the year, is at the line shooting two. One more.
Well, this offense has got the crowd quiet.
Yes.
The zoo is usually stepping up and after it.
Never used all the rim, but he gets them both. And that ends eight unanswered for Pitt.
Look at the size on the top by Sutton. Very tough to make a pass across. Got the kick.
Sutton kicks it. 54.3 to go. And a four-point margin. Patterson, Trayvon Woodall, Robinson, Gibbs, and Taylor on the floor for Jamie Dixon's squad. Nice. Equally nice. Sutton's had some quality time here.
This kid does a lot of nice little things, subtle things that influence the game. And they're going to go late on this one, I think. If you're Pitt, be solid and rebound. And conversely, run a good screen, I'd say 5 seconds or less.
Okay.
Give you a chance to get an offensive rebound, maybe, if you're Villanova. They're going 1-4 flat. They like this with Waynes. Maybe a late run out.
Five on the shot clock, eight game clock. Waynes, spin. Oh, he's too late. Shot clock violation.
Unbelievable. He's
oofed off.
You know, by the time he turned around to see when Jay wanted to go, he lost track of the clock. And of course, the big body, too, made it a very tough situation. He thought he could blow by. Good footwork. Solid defense.
Well, there's a wasted possession for Villanova. And Taylor was sent. 4.4 to go.
Put it in your hands of your speed guys, Gibbs or Woodall. and look deep. Speed dribble and go.
Woodall.
Nice.
Sutton, clean block. Maurice Sutton, an inspirational last 5 minutes.
Now you mentioned his influence, Fern.
Well, that's the end of the half with the score 22-18 Pitt. We will send you to Greg Gumbel in New York with AT&T at the half after these messages. You are watching CBS Sports on our 30th road to the Final Four.
My sister's new boyfriend told her that he thinks Sundays are just for watching football. Believe that?
Remain calm. Answering incorrectly has...
But I just...
consequences. But you're smart, right? You ordered off McDonald's Dollar Menu at breakfast, got the premium roast coffee, the savory sausage burrito, everything so good and just a buck each. You made it happen, so you got this.
He's a jerk.
Well played. McDonald's Dollar Menu at breakfast, the simple joy of being smart.
When a job calls for more muscle than a drill, Craftsman Impact Drivers answer the call, delivering over 3,000 impacts per minute, giving you greater torque for greater force to power through the toughest jobs. Craftsman, trust in your hands.
Survival's all about staying power. So who's antiperspirant will make them the last man standing. Put on the meat ponchos. The Degree Adrenaline Series responds to spikes in adrenaline with twice the sweat blocking power, which is good. The sweat
is like tasty gravy to a hungry wolf.
Looks dry to me.
Looks dry to me too, Bear.
Try the long-lasting Degree Adrenaline Series.
Absolutely. I mean, these financial services companies are still talking about retirement like it's some kind of dream. It's either this magic number I'm supposed to reach or... it's beach homes or starting a vineyard. Come on, just help me figure it out in a practical, let's make this happen kind of way. A vineyard? Give me a break.
Look for answers to your retirement questions? Get real, get started. Talk to Chuck.
When a job calls for more muscle than a drill, Craftsman Impact Drivers answer the call, delivering over 3,000 impacts per minute, giving you greater torque for greater force to power through the toughest jobs. Craftsman, trust in your hands.
Greg Gumbel in New York, coming up on AT&T at the half. Scores and highlights, including Notre Dame and UConn going down to the wire after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports College Basketball coverage is sponsored by Chrysler. The Capital One Venture Card. What's in your wallet? And by Applebee's. Applebee's is jazzing up the 2-for-20 menu with the all-new flavors of Bourbon Street. We are back in Pittsburgh. Here are the halftime stats brought to you by Reese.
Yeah, I think the rebound's a key factor and the points off the turnover, certainly. And also... Ashton Gibbs with a solid performance. Slow down, burn basketball by Villanova has kept the numbers down.
Low point totals, first half of play for both teams. As we get underway, 22-18. Vern Lundquist, Bill Raftery in Pittsburgh.
Well, McGee, a little strength, a little jump hook.
A little too strong. And Dominic Cheek clears it for Villanova.
Once again, patience, not in a hurry. I think they're going to get better shots at the end of it, though, Vern. Maybe start in at 15-14 versus 8-7.
And again, the shot clock in single digits. There's Fisher on the curl, waves, jumper. Yes.
Hide and seek off the big wide body of Yaru. Well, that's satisfying. You get both. You control the clock and you ring the bell.
That's bonus. Waynes is averaging only 24% from three-point range this year. That is the first Villanova field goal in the last 7 minutes in encompassing in the first half. And now McGee, no. Yaru on the floor, saves it. Cheek has it for Villanova.
And that's the one they got to get. Anything up for grabs, Villanova's got to get a hold of. Well, you got to finish that if you're McGee, don't you?
That's the second he's missed from close range. And Jay Wright is going to send Maurice Sutton back on the floor. Had that fine 5 minutes at the end of the first half. Here's Waynes. chance for Villanova to reclaim the lead. Jumper. No. McGee clears it.
Fisher does a nice job getting free using that baseline bump.
Oh, what a beautiful pass.
And once again, Robinson, the guy that knows how to get himself available, and Wanamaker, fourth assist. Not ringing the bell much. 0 for 3, but finding his partners.
Pena. Now they'll work it around and down again. Jumper into the corner. That's for three. In and out? No. Giroux with the offensive board.
And they got away with one.
Pena.
Terrific inside pass by Giroux. First grabbing a hold of it and then finding his guy. Solid play.
Now Villanova sliding again at the end of the year as they did last year. They've lost five of their last seven and trying to win at the peak for the first time ever. They're 0-3 here.
Tough there. Out of bounds.
On the line.
The ability to get free, something that's very important. And early in the game, they weren't finding guys on the box area, but good hustle play, the extra pass from Giroux, sent it in by Pena, and causing the turnover. Pretty good denial. Waynes may have gotten away of the bump there that caused the turnover.
Corey Fisher takes a seat. He's 2 of 9 from the field in this ballgame. Now Pena, Waynes, Sutton, Armwood, and Giroux. They've gone big.
One guard.
Yeah.
Well, you know he's going to turn the corner at some point. I would love to see them post up a little bit.
Here comes the high screen set by Giroux. Jumper Waynes off the mark. Tip, no. Gilbert Brown skies and grabs the loose ball.
And he can do that well.
Gibbs. Little crossover. Demonstration. Dig. And the finish not there from Nasir Robinson.
But pretty good patience by Villanova. They don't have it. Yank it back out.
And you can hear the members of the Oakland Zoo behind us, one of the great fan bases in the country.
Taking them out of the game.
Yeah, right? They really have. By the way, the show, as they call it in San Diego State last week, that jumper is good from Pena.
That's something I thought in the second half. He got some confidence against Notre Dame in a game that they really didn't play well. Steal something from it.
Wanamaker at the other end. Front rim, loose ball. And Armwood has it. Villanova back on top by one. The show in San Diego State, those kids are as clever as any student body I've ever seen. What they added to the game against Brigham Young last week was very close to being off color.
Well, I love my favorite side of all time was at Indiana for you.
Oh,
Vern for president.
Oh, yeah.
Am I mistaken?
Nothing much came of that.
What was your platform? Dinner for all?
Yes. Yeah, so, especially for me, can you tell? Wanamaker. Great speed.
Ooh, nice job attracting Sutton, though. Attacking the rim. The big fella negating. Foul, nevertheless.
2011 Conoco Mountain West Conference Men's Basketball Championship before the madness hits. Friday on the CBS College Sports Network.
You can win championships, but if you don't win that rivalry, it all means nothing. You're supposed to win that game, and I'm sure they feel the same way, but whatever happened in the last game before that is thrown out of the window. It's all about what you're going to do tonight.
Good is it to see those two guys, Grant Hill and Vince Carter. Well, there's always something at stake, and it will be the case tonight. Primetime, Duke and North Carolina, currently 13-2 in conference play. And Clark Kellogg will be joined courtside by Jimmer Nance.
Ooh.
Yep.
I'll tell you, though, there's a lot of great rivalries in the country.
Yes.
In basketball, I don't think there's any better, do you?
No, I do not.
Right now, Villanova heating up a little bit with a great game plan. Takes the starch out of the flow of the Pitt offense.
Well, we mentioned, Bill, that they had a slide at the end of last year, wound up losing to St. Mary's in the NCAA, trying to avoid the same kind of dilemma here Is there a difference last year this year?
Well, in talking to Jay, the one thing he felt last year, there were a lot of things that cropped up. Silly things, lateness. Remember they didn't start a couple guys in the tournament?
Right.
And this year it's been all positive. It's just not making shots, losing a little confidence, not coming up with the loose change, all of those things. So they felt they had a really good week. And I think with Stokes out, this is just a great presentation, great game plan. And see if Pitt can stimulate from their end some defensive stops and get some easy hooks.
We are tied at 25, so if you're a connoisseur of low-scoring basketball games, we've got something for you.
Maybe Kirill is somewhere smiling.
Yes.
And Louis Gonzaga, you should say Louis and Rolly, they wanted to win 4-2.
Pena. There's McGee, alters the shot and grabs the rebound.
And didn't foul. Great position, D, but a big fella.
Wanamaker for Pitt. Skip pass. Gilbert Brown, spin move. Oh, there's Sutton again. He's really played well today. Loose ball. Fisher, he's got Waynes to his left. Now he's got Waynes off the glass. And one.
What an adjustment. Full stride and great control by Fisher. The one thing if you're Villanova fan, you're saying, don't charge, Corey. Give it up early and look at this switch. The little smooch with the left. And a rolling Hadley. Tough finish.
That is the third foul on Wanamaker. He goes to the bench. Woodall's back on. And Malik Waynes shoots one more. Waynes has 10. Villanova's up by 3.
Half court trap now. Just a slow pit down a little bit. Make them use clock. They haven't. I was going to say they haven't stolen one, but they haven't yet.
Out of bounds off Waynes.
Pretty good secondary trap burn.
Jamie Dixon's team needs a win to secure the top seed in the Big East tournament next week and keep alive the dream, I think, of a number one seed overall for the NCAA tournament. Dixon.
Jamie knows this league's all about close games and what you do at the end, and he's got a lot of playmakers at the end of games, so they have been through it.
Robinson, dish. McGee, turn around, got it.
Did that slip?
Whoa!
That just slipped out of his hand.
It did,
but he's in the right spot.
Give me 2.
Mm-hmm.
Those are his first points for the senior. Mom and dad are here today. 4 seniors honored in pregame ceremonies. 3 play a lot. The 4th is a walk-on, Nick Rivers.
I'm getting nervous about us. We see the parents, and they look so much younger than we do. Oh,
yeah. Sutton slips.
Pretty pass.
Underneath. Clean block by McGee. Here's Gilbert Brown. Gibbs. Robinson wanted it up in the air, but instead Gibbs takes the jumper. And Jay Wright calls time.
What is luxury? It's an engine that delivers 25% more power using less fuel. An ingenious suspension system that drives like a sports sedan. It's a world's first around view monitor that provides a virtual 360 degrees of visibility. What is luxury? It's the all new Infiniti QX. This is inspired performance. This is the way of Infiniti.
Trouble in paradise. A fatal dive. Was it murder? Tonight.
Verizon believes that no small business should be invisible, so we decided to help a real small business make it easier for customers to find them.
My name's Elizabeth Hines. We're at Isabella's Boutique in Rock Center, New York.
Do me a favor and search for your business.
All right.
What'd you find?
Nothing.
I mean, if you don't have a website, you're basically invisible.
40% of small businesses don't have a website, but with Verizon websites powered by Intuit, it's so easy you can do it yourself, and so powerful it can make any small business more visible.
Add photos. Then we'll hit publish.
I have a website?
You have a website.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe it was that easy.
Verizon can put your small business on over 100 search sites so customers can find you with a personalized business email address that connects with your site.
Visit me at isabellasny.com.
Small business. Visible. Call today and get a six-month free trial of Verizon websites powered by Intuit when you sign up for Verizon's reliable high-speed internet and phone for business, just $59.99 a month with no term contract required. Verizon, the hardest working network in business.
This is comparable to the Corolla.
Toyota. Why do so many car companies compare themselves to Corolla? Maybe it's because Corolla is the number one selling car of all time. Or because the Corolla was awarded a 2011 IIHS Top Safety Pick. Lease a 2010 Toyota Corolla for just $149 a month, or get 0% APR financing for 60 months. And when you lease or finance Corolla, get an additional $500 in down payment assistance. We're number one for a reason. Come see for yourself. Hurry in for the best selection.
CBSNewYork.com. Get news, get updates, get more out of New York.
Well, Vern, as they say here in Pittsburgh, one of the local riders, me and Gary McKee. How about the big foul? I think he was almost just given the foul there. Gets a lot of the ball. And you love how you shorten the floor. You can't get the defense. Your balance goes to the rim and then peel out. But Gibbs, one of the guys, you mentioned the first half, he's able to convert the pull-up jumper. He's finding spots to get that three. You can't give him room. He also has improved his ability to get to the rim. But the pull-up, the mid-range game, and look who started to. Brandon Knight, former great at Seton Hall Prep. Dad played for yours.
Yes.
Truly. Certainly he taught me more than I taught him. No question about it, Mel Knight. But a very promised up-and-coming coach.
Well, not much doubt that Brandon Knight is going to be the head coach soon. I talked to a couple of his professors yesterday, Rob Ruck and Marcus Redeker. And they taught him throughout his academic career here. They put him, Brandon Knight I'm talking about, in the same category as Shane Battier.
Wow.
I mean, that is as high praise as you can get.
And great parents, too. Part of the reason for that as well.
Yes.
Brendan Mel.
Waynes. Oh, he's having a fine game.
He's tough. He really is. He's got that great little knack of gathering his feet quickly. And down the road, he'll be a much better three-point shooter.
Sutton kicked it. This is the eighth lead change we've had in this game. 30-29.
Come on, it's good.
Quiet all of a sudden.
Yeah, it does. Sutton got to be a little under control as he comes for that trap. He's big enough, he doesn't have to jump.
The zoo went mute.
Mm-hmm. His slow game takes away the peanuts.
Yeah. Lamar Peterson's. Patterson's on the floor. And there's Yaru. Build your brackets with Lowe's and CBS Sports on Facebook. Play against your friends and for a chance to win a trip to the 2012 Final Four. Sign up at facebook.com/brackets. Fisher, you mentioned the yo-yo that Jay Wright has him on because of the three fouls.
Yeah, he wants to save him down the stretch. Good move, chief, good defender, lengthy, another guy that can challenge shots. There, Gibbs didn't get a clean look because of that length.
Onward just picked up his third foul. We're nearing the 12-minute mark. Gibbs, no. Dante Taylor up and under, got it.
Wow, he is one of the big, strong guys that can carve out area. And keeper Villanova, don't give up those offensive opportunities. I think they may have a warning on slapping the ball, if I'm not mistaken.
All right, time has been called. 11:54 to go. Close encounter here in Pittsburgh. CBS Sports College Basketball coverage is sponsored by Buick. See real stories of human achievement on the Buick Human Highlight Reel coming in March. Buffalo Wild Wings, you have to be here. And by Lowe's. Lowe's, let's build something together. In Pittsburgh, Pitt by one over Villanova, 31-30. As we went to break, we saw this little inadvertent elbow thrown.
Unfortunately, Aru, that's why they stopped the play. It wasn't a bench warning, but how about Taylor? Four of his five rebounds are on the offensive boards, and looks like Aru is okay, but you got to keep those guys off the glass. That's key for Villanova as they try and seize this one.
There is Aru.
Corey Fisher's back on the floor with Waynes. Maurice Sutton, number 25, is still there, and so is Pena, number zero. And for Pitt, Ashton Gibbs, Trayvon Woodall, Robinson, Patterson, and Dante Taylor. Shot clock in single digits again.
Oh boy,
Taylor threw a hip.
Well, you know, I don't think so. No, I would teach kids to go right at that hip.
Okay.
Because the refs have to call it. I mean, it's when you show, you got to be under control, hand, and then get that leg out of there. Your job is to recover basically to your man.
Wanamaker's back. Nasir Robinson and Gibbs are on the bench. Gilbert Brown's also back on the floor now for Pitt.
And Pena, one of those guys, I think, can get a little jump shot on some penetration. Starting to play and shoot it with a little confidence.
Wanamaker on Waynes. He pulls up, takes the jumper, air ball. Cue the zoo.
Yeah, what did you say? I'm very subdued.
Yeah.
It's not closing time.
And again, Fisher on the bench, trying to conserve his playing time. You sure there's a shot clock in this game?
It puts a lot of pressure on the drive from Villanova. Don't you think they come up with a open look?
Wanamaker. Guarded by Dominic Cheek. Here's Gilbert Brown.
Yeah. Good ball reversal. That's one thing they do well.
And with that basket, Gilbert Brown has joined the group who in their career at Pittsburgh have scored 1,000 points or more. Switch, Waynes. Sutton, no,
got his game.
Wanamaker, Woodall, all the way, got it. Timeout, Villanova.
Jack Link's Beef Jerky presents Messin' with Sasquatch.
Here you go.
Big guy, you want to play with us? I'm gonna put this ball right here, and you're gonna give it a big old kick. Come on!
Jack Link's Jerky. Feed your wild side.
Well, this is just a sample, is it not? March Madness is coming, and you can experience it in a whole new way. Every game in its entirety on four different networks. It all begins March 13th with Selection Sunday on CBS. The first four from Dayton Tuesday and Wednesday on True TV. Second and third rounds March 17th through 20th on four networks. Then the regionals will be shared by CBS and TBS. That's on March 24th through 27th. And the final four on CBS from Houston, April 2nd and 4th.
Should be a pretty good one. And when you play close to the vest like Villanova's, you must get good shots. Last two trips, bad shots. Brown knocks the one down, and then they convert.
Largest lead of the game for Pitt now at 6. Here's Fisher. Yeru high screen. Fisher short. Out of bounds. Hit ball.
Waynes had a tough look. And the ability to get the ball from side to side. Look at the defense has to come out. Pena a little bit late. And the jump shot by Sutton, and look at the run out here. McGee with a great screen to open it up. Pretty good play by Cheek to almost get a piece of it.
Lamar Patterson is on the floor for Pitt. He has the ball. Trayvon Woodall gets it. Now Armwood way out. Side. Dominic Cheek picks up Woodall. 9:15 to go.
A little cheap one over there, a little small change. Is it Yarou?
I believe it was Yarou. That's his second. And Sutton is quickly on for Isaiah Armour.
And Vern, the one thing with Pitt, they have not used their guards to screen as much. They're not getting the double screen they like to run. And part of it's Villanova's pretty good defense. Look at this.
That's him. Well, they are the second best rebounding team in the country, and that helps to a 9-0 run.
And just the slide by McGee, the great footwork, he's made himself a player. 28-18 in the rebounding category, favoring Pitt.
Fisher, nice.
Pretty hesitation.
Yes.
Showing some strength. Kiss. The Bronx.
Fisher goes for the steal.
Got it. Hit Brown.
Got the ball.
How about this? Just a little slide, being in the right spot with that big body. And if he came down, he may not have gotten it. But here is just a show of terrific upper body strength and a little touch.
Now Dominic Cheek leaves for Villanova. Trayvon Woodall leaves. And at the pit end, he just walked over to the baseline, shook hands with four of the members of the Zoo. Very casual approach.
Well, you got to learn how to win against all types of offenses. That's what I think Pitt's very good at. I mean, they didn't beat Notre Dame, but I think they probably learned a lot about being patient. Almost a double dribble.
Jumper for three. No. McGee with another rebound. Here's Gibbs. Patterson. McGee wasn't ready for it.
It wasn't a good look at him, though.
And then he fires it underneath to Patterson and Sutton. Wow. His ball for the foul.
I thought he did a nice job, Sutton, staying tall. Whew.
Well, what's at stake? Top seed in the Big East. Pitt fans are enjoying it so far.
What do you say, Vern? You can't continually get down here. One more, excuse me. The rebounding has been extraordinary. McGee in particular. I think it's the big body's wear on you when you play Pitt. You rotate so many people. Tough to compete.
Well, they are down by six. Do they, Villanova, do they have the resiliency now to get back in this thing?
I think they'll still play the same way, just okay, for a little while longer. But if it gets to 10, I think you'll see them push the ball a little bit more. I think the decision when to go and what kind of shot is key here for Villanova as they try and, you know, get back in contact.
It's good to see you again.
Same here. It's been a while.
You know, every March they say, put the Sunshine Boys together again.
It's always delightful. On and off, I might say.
Patterson at the line, number 21. And so the margin is 7.
Big thing now, Vern. What are you going to run? Whose hands do you want it in? You don't have the deep threat. That's why I thought Pena might, on some ball motion towards the rim, get himself a shot. He's the small forward in this lineup.
Fisher and Wayne's the guard. Sutton, Yarou, the bigs. There's Pena left wing. Now he can hit from outside.
Not quite that distance, but oh, nice slap. What a play. Rake in the post. Oh, that is terrific. Boy, that's playing your guy and helping out on the postman. Just terrific.
That is the first Villanova turnover in this half. They have only 6 for the game.
which obviously has helped keep them competitive in this one.
There's that little screening, back screen pop now by Gibbs. The automatic switch, good preparation. Can't get out on him. Gibbs, yep, Pena just can't cover that guy. That's what they had not been doing, using the guards to screen. And that's why Jamie Dixon wins on a terrific basis year in and year out. Preparation.
Tomorrow on CBS, the mayor of Cincinnati is going undercover. But how does the most recognizable person in the city keep from blowing his cover? All new Undercover Boss tomorrow only. CBS. 14-2 hit run.
Execution. Coming down the stretch. Trademark of Pitt. Get to that point where you're going to have to attack.
Yeah, I don't think they can work the clock.
Not too many more trips.
Fisher.
Chop.
No. McGee with another big rebound.
And nice coaching, too. You're coming up that side. Defense hugged him on the hip. He's coming back to shoot to his right side, Fisher. Not as effective.
Fisher now 3 of 13.
Same play. Pop get another screen.
Here's Gibbs and Wanamaker.
A little more fluidity in their offense now. Ooh, goodness.
Oh.
Fisher looking for a little handkerchief, maybe. A little counter. Use of the clock here.
5 on the shot clock. Wanamaker in and out. Yaru chases it down. Finds Malik Wayans. Under 6 to play now.
Tough shot.
Oh, boy.
Tough runner. That's his game, though. You know, the difficulty for Villanova, too, in terms of offense is a lot of these guys haven't played together as a unit. So what do you run when it's a dribble-drive unit most of the time?
Patterson hits from the bench. Dante Taylor comes back on. Gary McGee gets a nice hand as the senior goes by Jamie Dixon and Brandon Knight. Here's Isaiah Armwood, 5:48 to go.
Keep bringing in fresh bodies, don't they? Back on defense. Usually, when you're taunted like that, which has happened in our careers, usually try and retaliate.
Wayans has 15
nice
points.
Hustle. And
nice. Whoa.
Walk.
Offensive foul.
I thought you were going to give him a walk first.
Nasir Robinson took the charge.
Great step in. Solid. That's hanging in and reading.
Let's that just, was Pena.
Let's just check. See, I think he may have walked before, but great position, Dave.
Ashton Gibbs will inbound the Pitt. If Pitt wins, they get the top seed in the Big East tournament that begins Tuesday in New York.
Watch Gibbs. If you'd like to run a screen for him.
Villanova can wind up anywhere from 6 to 11, depending on all the action in the final regular season weekend of the Big East. There's a foul on Malik Wayans. Well, once again, that's 3 fouls on Wayans, so both guards with 3. Villanova stays alive for a first-round bye. If they win today, Pittsburgh will clinch the East. Notre Dame won earlier. They do hold a tiebreaker edge over Pitt because they won here. That's the only defeat at home this year for Pitt.
A nice refusal. Look at the position. That's his angle, too. I think they got a charge before on the baseline. Wanamaker, boy, good understanding. Location, into the right spot. You know a lot about real estate with your holdings. Get your body organized so we know where you are.
You mean my debt. Yeah. Wanamaker has picked up his 4th, so he gets to join Jamie Dixon on the bench.
I don't think we're running a benefit for you, though.
No, no. I'm not claiming that. 4:50.
Still willing to utilize the clock.
Fisher and Pena, Dominic Cheek, Isaiah Armwood, and Sutton.
Look was a big trip, I think, for Villanova. We hit the space dribble and the shot.
This year, 3 of 13 from the field. Shot clock at 10, and a little reach-in foul called on Gilbert Brown, number 5.
Oof. Boy, does that help Villanova. They were really in trouble, I thought.
Wayne's back. He'll replace Cheek.
I didn't call a low post basket.
No.
Drive.
Yeah.
Manufactured it. But not a catch turn.
Wings. Dante Taylor was a presence defensively. And again, the shot clock winding down. Jumper Wayne's way outside.
Wow.
That'll keep you close.
This kid against Syracuse, he hit 3 in a row early. And he's got confidence. He's going to get better at that part of the game, and they're right back in touchdown.
Yes, they are. They've clawed back to within 5. Wayne's has 14 in this half. A foul is called, and Pitt's going to shoot free throws. 43-38. Big East basketball on CBS. Take a look at the Capital One Impact performance.
And he has had an impact during his career and developed a lot to his game. It's just not that beautiful stroke from deep. Well organized. He screens well, knows how to get himself free. They run a lot of good stuff for him. And Villanova on the other end, only 4 assists on their 15 field goals, which tells you a lot of dribbling, a lot of going on your own. And fortunately for them, at least the ability deep from Malik Wayne's has got them in touch again. But Gibbs has been, as usual, terrific.
And just to give full value, that's the Capital One Cup Impact.
Well, good. I'm ready to straighten that out.
Don't want to shortchange anybody. 43-38.
Now, you had a chance to talk to Jamie Dixon's dad, right?
Yeah.
In from California.
Yeah. Mr. Dixon's here for a couple of weeks. And Jamie's mom is going to join the family, his sister Julie as well, in New York next week. Jamie says, I do not have responsibility for tickets. None. None.
He is totally focused on his job.
You know, Steve Peterson told me something interesting yesterday about Jamie Dixon. He worked with Ben Howland in Northern Arizona when they hired Ben to be the head coach here. He said, I only have one demand. I don't care about country club memberships or anything like that. I want Jamie Dixon as my assistant. Now, the problem there was that Jamie had fallen in love with a young woman in Hawaii. He was an assistant in Hawaii.
Mm-hmm.
And Steve said, Howland said, you got to get him here. So there's the challenge from Honolulu to Pittsburgh. I'm just saying.
I know, I understand, but they didn't have the Weather Channel in. He thought it was peaches and cream here, but again, a settle deep because not a whole lot happening up front offensively for Villanova. And now they've got the hammer burn. They can milk this.
Yeah.
Get what they want. More weapons. Coming late in the shot clock. Nice hands. Fisher.
Gilbert Brown in the lane. Timeout. Timeout called by Pitt. '45-38 with under 3 to play tomorrow on CBS. The Amazing Race is in Japan, where the team slip, slide, and take aim to stay in the game. New Amazing Race tomorrow only. CBS. Well, Jamie Dixon ending his 8th season here, and look, he's the fastest coach ever. Most wins at the end of 8 years, surpassing Everett Case and Roy Williams.
And pretty good D on the slap.
Shot clock.
See, that's one of those rules. If you've got a chance, let it go. Right?
Yeah.
I mean, thanks for, if it hurts Villanova actually on that particular play, but there's not much you can do. That's the rule. Interesting. 6 seconds on. They got a good look to Pittsburgh, but a great challenge to the gate.
Armwood comes out to set the screen. There's the switch.
Nice help by McGee. Look at him hustle back.
Yes.
elbow thrown, a ball.
They got a timeout? Or was he out of bounds?
Separate the bodies and see.
How about that? Yeah. Heads up.
...45-38 with 2:37 remaining in regulation. Villanova with one timeout remaining. Pittsburgh has two. Foul 7-4 in the possession arrow in favor of the Wildcats.
I think Pena, he's been so unused to touching the ball, fumbled that. I mean, he hasn't touched it in a while on the offensive end. Pretty good find on the penetration.
Nasir Robinson inbounds. Trayvon Woodall also on the floor. Ashton Gibbs, keep in mind, Wanamaker sits with four fouls. Here's Gilbert Brown. There's Sutton. That's McGee. And Pena knocked it loose. It was tipped out of bounds. Touch last by Pena.
Great cover by Pena. They left it bare. He got himself back in position. Just a great, look how far he came from, Vern. Magnificent effort, McGee. My last senior home game, they took away my candy.
Wanamaker comes on. Nasir Robinson will rest. 2:26 to go. And a 7-point margin.
Hold, I think, by Cheek. Yeah. That's one way of trying to stop Gibbs.
Team fouls now 8 for Villanova. Pitt still with fouls to give. And Pittsburgh has done well at the free throw line tonight, 10 of 12.
And this guy's pretty good at 88%. What you want from your point guard.
Well, Ashton Gibbs in Big East, even more proficient. He's now 39 of 42 in Big East play this year.
I think
now, Fisher.
He's hurt, I think. He's
limping a little bit as he heads to the bench.
Yeah, he's been banged up a little bit, too.
So James Bell will come on. Dominic Cheek also sits down. And Gibbs at the line where he excels.
I think you get an overdrive now if you're going up. Gotta come at it. Fisher coming back, but I think they're going to keep it. They got to keep the possession out, if I'm
right.
Not mistaken.
Ashton Gibbs has 16 points. For three. McGee and a foul call.
And I think Armwood down underneath. Jacking him and not really creating. Helps the opponent.
And Gary McGee is going to remember his senior night at Pitt. He's now got 10 rebounds in this ball game.
Just does his job. And when he came in, a lot of people were unsure whether he'd be a factor in the
right.
Big East. Under the tutelage of Jamie and his assistants, they've prospered a lot of these guys.
I remember he played behind DeJuan Blair for a couple of years.
Yeah.
Blair declared for the NBA, now in San Antonio.
And not doing badly either.
No.
Well, he was a charismatic guy, too.
Now these three seniors, four if you've got Nick Rivers, and you should, about to win their 110th game, and 52 of them have come after DeJuan Blair left school. 52 wins in the last couple of years.
Now Villanova is just going after their normal early action right now.
Fisher,
whoops, yeah, not going to get anywhere. And Jamie just saying, open it up a little bit. Now you give them a taste of what they've been doing. Unless something really good happens early.
Patterson, clock under two.
Well, there'll be a celebration in Pittsburgh, I think, Brian.
Mm-hmm.
Good screen by McGee. Little toss
in the glass. Good.
Well, credit to penetration. but it's McGee who just wraps up the opponent in a legal fashion.
Eight unanswered now for Pitt, and they have put this one away. Waynes, well, maybe not.
Quick timeout?
Yeah.
Last one.
That's for three. Time to call Villanova. Villanova out of timeouts. They do have a possession arrow, but it's a formidable task now, facing a 10-point deficit with 1:20 to go and an inability to stop the clock.
It's nice having Woodall on the team as well, because now you put Gibbs off the ball, play a little smaller with Wanamaker. And McGee, a tribute to tenacity, I think.
If Pitt wins, they go 15-3 in the Big East. That equals their best record ever. That was in 09, 08, 09, when these two teams in the regional finals in Boston engaged in one of the best games I've ever seen. Mm-hmm.
Yep. Yeah, I would agree. A little trap causes the turnover. Yep. Stepped on the end line, I think. Now, you mentioned how Ben Howland wanted Jamie Dixon first thing. The proudest guy other than the Dixon family is Ben Howland.
Yeah.
For the job he's done here. And Jamie wants to know what the call was.
Yeah.
Got his answer. Bill Hillgrove in the background. Radio announcer here for Pittsburgh. And the Steelers, I might add, alongside Dick Rose.
Ah, another three. How about Waynes?
He's a gamer, this kid.
Yes. And it's a 7-point game with 106 to go. Malik Waynes with 5 3-point baskets, 24 points in all. McGee's out. Patterson's in.
Now, at this point, how are you going to deny? Where are you going to trap? Home run.
Brown brings it back outside, puts it in the hands of Trayvon Woodall. 1 minute to go.
A lot of handlers on the floor right now.
Wanamaker.
Look at this.
Brown, Gibbs.
Tough covers.
Woodall. Brown wants it in the corner. And a little reach-in foul on Isaiah Armwood. That's... And a little bump.
I got
now.
A technical on Armwood.
Armwood.
Now, there's a little incident early in the year with Armwood on a reach around.
Yes.
Where he struck.
First game.
Nasir Robinson. And, you know, all this little nickel dime stuff. It's not basketball. And I don't mind that one. I don't think that was as bad as a little bang later. And Jay's talking to him right away.
Now, in game one, there was a technical foul. That was a tough ball game between these two, 57-54. And what was deemed an intentional foul by Armwood in that first game. .1 left. So the personal foul is on Armwood and the technical foul on Armwood, and he is done for the day. Armwood finished.
Then Woodall will shoot the two, then we'll have the other two, and then the ball. Is the initial foul.
And now Ashton Gibbs.
And right here, this is the giveaway, and at the end of this, this control. I don't think that was bad on something, but then it was Armwood who got involved again. Just mark those down. It's like the automatic walk for...
Yes.
Intentional walk, I should say.
Gibbs perfect to the line, as he has been in Big East play, with the exception of three misses.
He's 6 of 6 today. And it's back to a double-digit lead now, 55-44, 43.1 to go. Woodall, Cheek, will shoot more free throws. You can hear behind us, we want Rivers. That's Nick Rivers, who is the fourth senior, started as a student manager here and has played on the varsity for the last couple of years. Gosh, that sounds like a strange thing to say, on the varsity.
Well, that's a throwback.
Yeah, it is, isn't it?
And Jamie's over there. He's not sure this is over.
Exactly. You know,
finally sat down. Nice combo in the backcourt with Woodall and Gibbs.
Don't forget Duke, North Carolina coming up tonight. Prime time in Chapel Hill. Waynes. Rebound, Gilbert Brown. Nick Rivers is going to get the play in his final game. At, I think he was coming in.
I think he ran down there on his own, baby.
Maybe so.
That was pretty funny.
Oh, my goodness. He was halfway to the scores table. And now he's at the end of the bench. Pittsburgh, how well have they done at the free throw line today? They're now 21 of 23. Here comes the ovation. Nick Rivers.
In a city known for its rivers, how about this applause?
Well, I think it's a combination for the victory and the Big East Championship and the appearance of Nick Rivers. Boy, have they excelled at the free throw line today.
They are tough in a lot of areas, particularly in the last 5 minutes of a game, Vern.
Gilbert Brown's last game. He heads to the bench where he joins Gary McGee. Waynes, another one, that's 6 threes.
He will not stop playing that kid.
Whistle and a foul.
Villanova doesn't want them to celebrate.
Yeah. 59-47 with 26.2 to go. Jay Wright will await the conclusion of Big East play today to find out whether they have to play on Tuesday. So many variations that do you think the Big East is going to get 11 teams in?
Wow. I mean, you talk to different people around the country, it's hard to not put the 11 in.
Right.
But, you know, remains to be seen, and that's why selection show is worth watching, right?
Cincinnati beat Georgetown.
The Marquette will be a team up
yes.
there, you know, that...
From the corner, nope. Putback is good. Foul, Maurice Sutton. 12.6 to go. Pitt's going to go to 27-4 for the season. Lost earlier in the year to Tennessee. Lost at home to Notre Dame. At St. John's. Already had a brilliant game in that one. And then most recently at Louisville in overtime. But... what a solid season for the Pitt Panthers.
They sure have. There's Villanova with a good game plan. Not to match the quality of Pitt.
Pitt, your Big East champions.
Once again, we ask you, ladies and gentlemen,
for Bill Raftery, Vern Lundquist saying so long from Pittsburgh. Final score 60-50 Pitt. Don't forget tonight on CBS, it's Duke against North Carolina. We'll send you to Greg Gumbel in New York with a road to the Final Four right after this on our 30th road to the Final Four.
Hello. everyone, and welcome to the road to the Final Four. I'm Greg Gumbel in New York alongside my cohorts, Greg, Anthony, and Seth Davis. With a reminder, coming up later at 8 Eastern tonight, Duke squares off with North Carolina. And then tonight on CBS continues with a 48 Hours mystery, Trouble in Paradise. A couple goes diving in the Caribbean, but only one of them comes back up. Was it an accident or murder? That's all ahead tonight on CBS. The game just completed here on CBS. Pittsburgh by 10 over Villanova. Seth, impressive performance by the Panthers because Notre Dame just put it right in their faces and said, you got to do something with
this. And they were able to keep the number one seed in the Big East tournament, keep alive their hopes for number one seed in the NCAA tournament. And my goodness, the Villanova Wildcats are really going south at the worst possible time. They need to get Corey Stokes healthy, obviously, but Corey Fisher has just had a disappointing season and a very bad month of February. You talk about going 3-for-14 overall from the field, 1-for-8 from three-point range, and they only made 4 free throws today. Not going to work.
Meanwhile, Pittsburgh a winner by a score of 60-50. Elsewhere on the scoreboard, along with the highlights, Wyoming traveled to